I'm away, mate. What are you doing?
What?
Away.
What am I doing in the van?
I've had to drag it out your house, haven't I? But, no, we've got to get down to London.
Oh.
We'll let Tommy see you this time.
What time are we up today?
Half five, mate.
Half five, ouch.
Up at half five, started recording my own sort of stuff. Quarter past six, then I sprinted over the road. Because guess who was outside me out? Said they were over to the van.
Hi, Kirsty.
Hello, Gav.
How are you feeling this morning?
All right, mate.
What time were you up?
5 to 5, mate.
5 to 5?
Yeah.
You got some breakfast?
No. Couple of cups of coffee, which I'm feeling now, so we're going to be having a rather early pit stop.
Yeah. What time are you expecting us to do everything today? So first pit stop, what time are you saying?
In the next 5 minutes. By the weather be, I'm absolutely busting.
Hey, JT, where's Guesty gone?
Some say the little boy's room, Gav.
The very little boy's room. Guesty.
What, Gav?
You're going to be driving in London traffic. Have you ever done it before?
No.
Are you a bit worried?
No, not really. You can only get some at once, can't you? That's it.
I mean, a lot of people may not know this, but you're on a massive health kick, aren't you?
Yeah, six and a half stone now, yeah.
6.5 stone lost?
Yeah.
Since when, how many months?
Since last October.
October?
Yeah.
So almost a year?
Yeah.
6.5 stone, that's class.
Almost a year, without the palm or anything nice. Which is quite good, because food's amazing.
I couldn't do it.
Food is divine.
Do you know who else couldn't give up Parmos?
I wonder why the band was listening.
Yep.
Hey, JT, my friend.
Yes.
Do you know what time it's for? The AJT bet.
That's the one.
So, what are we going for today?
2-1, and I'm feeling a samba longa.
Right, okay.
That's what I'm feeling, Gav. I feel like they will score first.
Right.
Just to put it out there.
Okay. Now, I'm going for a 1-1. You know.
Sit on the fence over there, Gav.
I don't care. I'm winning money
the
today.
The fence over there. You might as well sit on the fence over there.
I'm winning money today, and 1-1 is the money bet.
Have you backed the 1-1?
No, I don't have that much money for it, to be honest, but if I had money, it'd be 1-1.
I fell asleep once.
Yeah, yeah. On the way back, I'm expecting a 5-hour nap.
No, literally on the way back, so you're getting the bottom of sleep. Yeah. I'm serious.
Absolutely. He gives the interview, he puts all into the interview,
Yeah. Obviously, if somebody scores, I will be kissing his feet tonight. Obviously.
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 Obviously. Okay, here we are, we're at the services, me and Mr. Tony Guess. How's it going, Tony?
All right, Gav.
How's the drive going for you?
All right.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like you say, where are we? Stibbington down there or somewhere down south.
Yeah, down south.
Like it.
I mean, we've got about just under 100 miles to go now.
Yeah.
So that's not too bad, about 2 hours it's saying our sat nav.
Yeah.
So we should be there soon.
Oh yeah.
And we've got plenty of time to spare as well, so hopefully we can have a good look around this this old stadium. What are you expecting from today's game, Mr. Tony Guess?
Point.
Just a point, yeah?
I'll be over the moon with a point, Gav. 3 points, absolutely over the moon.
Yeah.
But like you say, with Villa, if we come away from a point at places like Fulham, like you say, keep our unbeaten record intact.
Yeah.
That would be good, Gav. We've gone 5 games now unbeaten. Conceded 2 sloppy goals against QPR. Apart from that, we've been rock solid at the back. So hopefully, like you say, one is if we come away with a 0-0, a clean sheet, you know, but a win would be a massive bonus, and that would be pointing in the right direction for hopefully, if the way things work out, we have two home games. We could be top of the league by the end of this, by the end of next Saturday.
Guesty.
Oh, Gav.
I spy with my little eye.
Gav.
Yeah.
Gav, come on, please.
Well, I've got another game, okay? It's called Guess the Ice Cream. Okay. First word is Rocky
Road.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Dead on, mate. Are we almost there, Guesty?
Really there, Gav.
Are we doing one more stop off though?
Oh yeah, we're desperate to get this.
The Guesty baby bladder has been bursting today. It's been constantly full. Third services?
Third services, yeah.
Not seen one single Borough fan yet?
Nah, they've been all there, Gav. No, they've all gone on the choo-choo.
About all this traffic going.
The mental. Who'd live here? Found out before.
5.7 miles.
Turn left onto A219, Shepherd's Bush Road.
AJT?
Yes.
Got a question for you, mate. We've just went past Shepherd's Bush. Who is this shepherd and why the bush?
Me.
Little coach in front of us, lads.
Follow up with the lads.
01642.
So we finally made it. What? How long have we been driving around now on the streets?
About an hour. But I don't know if it's about an hour. It came here about quarter past twelve.
Yeah, and it's quarter past one now. So yeah, about an hour. We've been driving around the streets. If you haven't been to Fulham, the Fulham ground before, there's zero parking, and we keep getting told if we park anywhere, we're gonna get clamped.
Yeah.
So we're literally parked 1 mile away from the actual ground now, and we're gonna have to walk down.
Yeah.
Do our regging.
How's
the parking situation there?
Oh, I tell you what, I never ever ever want to come here again. Everything's restricted, mate.
Yeah. Literally every single street around the stadium says that you can only park there for an hour on match days. Obviously, unless you have a permit, you live there. But tell you what, we've parked a mile away now.
Yeah.
So let's go on with the trek.
It's a mile closer to home, Gav.
Suppose that's always a good way of thinking about it. Can't wait. Right, AJT, you got our tickets?
Yeah, mate.
Let's have a look at them.
I've only got one, Gav.
Where's the rest? Where's Guesty?
He's playing hide and seek, mate. He's gone to hide.
Oh, he's gone to hide?
Yeah.
Are you counting?
I'm counting, mate. You best go and hide, mate.
Yeah, but I better go and hide, right? Okay. So we're playing hide and seek. I've decided to come back down to the van. No, no, look here.
Yeah, young mate.
Yeah, what do you think of the first half?
Getting tortured down there, our right hand side.
Christie's not doing his best, is he?
I don't know whether Christie's just being exposed because Baker's pushing too far forward.
Do you think he might be a bit cautious because he's on a yellow card?
Maybe so. Maybe he's going to change at half time, bring friend on the move, maybe, of course.
Possibly.
Because they're going to end us sooner or later down that side. That Sessegnon's
It's all happening down that side, isn't it?
Yeah, Sessegnon's amazing. A lovely footballer.
Yeah, isn't he just fast? Yeah. You think he's fast?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Whips it in as well. Yeah, he does, doesn't he?
And obviously, Randolph again, kept us in the game. Three saves in the first 15 minutes.
Superb.
We just played normal, but we're struggling to get the ball forward quick enough.
We need to do a lot better than that, but keep the faith, Tone.
Oh, definitely. I still fancy us.
Fancy you, Tone.
Ah. Up the butter.
I think I'm winning at this time. It's been about an hour, no sign of Guesty or AJT. I'm too good at this hide and seek lark. It's been about an hour and a half since I've been hiding. You know, I should probably get back to the ground now. The match is probably going to start without me.
At this point in time, we did the interviews with the fans. Have a check on our YouTube channel if you haven't seen them yet. They were fantastic today.
Do I save into the vlog?
Huh?
Do I save into the vlog?
Good one. One job.
Cheers, man.
All right.
Nice one, Dale. What are you going to say to it?
Come on,
pop the right, interview's done, back in the van.
Here with Tony Guest, our driver. Tony, I mean, I outdid you when it came to hide and seek, mate. I mean, I don't know what happened to you, but I was hiding for at least 3 hours there. What happened to you, mate? Did you get found straight away, did you? Didn't you do very well?
We weren't playing hide and seek, yeah.
What?
We weren't playing hide and seek. You didn't have a ticket, mate. Okay. Sorry, honestly, it's got nothing to do with me.
Shut up, you! Did he take my ticket?
He did.
Guesty?
Yes, Gav?
What do you think of the big yellow self-storage?
Big and it's yellow, Gav.
Stopped at some services as we were going to upload the interviews to YouTube ASAP, but we've come up with a problem. Tony, you're the technical guy out of the two of us. What's happened to the what's happened to the videos?
The free Wi-Fi isn't in such a hurry.
It's just slow.
Alright, Guesty, we're full of coffee, the van's full of petrol, AJ's full of burger, time to get off.
Right.
Mr. Guest.
Hey, up, Gav.
How are you doing?
Alright.
I know that you need to get home, it's pretty late now, but could you give us a roundup of the game today?
Game today was a slow start again. For some reason, we just seemed to not get on the front foot. Saying that, we had our first shot on 13 seconds. Lewis Baker had a really decent chance. Then we set into the pattern again, where it was tippy tappy pass across the midfield, and it just forced us further and further back, where Randolph made absolutely three fantastic saves in the first 15 minutes. Then, like you say, the first half just seemed to fizzle away from us.
where we seem to be under quite a lot of pressure. Sessegnon Young, and I think it was Adoja down their left, attacking Christie. Christie didn't get a look in, he was really left exposed. He struggled all the first half to deal with what was coming towards him. And if they'd have had a more committed centre forward, I think we'd have gone in 2-3 nil down at half time. But then again, like you say, typical Borough, come out totally different second half. We dominated for a good 20 minute spell where Bamford had this shot, like you say, with where that was, I thought it was in. They brought the big lad on up front. I can't think of his name. AK-47, I believe the Fulham fans call him. He came on and he looked really powerful and strong and big, and he caused some problems. But Dale Fry was absolutely immense against him. Dale came into his own again, and he, like you say, some of the tackles Dale was putting in the second half of the second half, you know, he just impresses every game. Then obviously down the left was where their goal was going to come from, and like you say, quality ball into the box, and there the AK-47 scored a good goal on the 85th minute, which was quite gutting because it looked like we were quite capable and quite comfortable of coming away with a 0-0 with a point. Then we got a corner, sloppy corner comes in, you know, barely comes to the edge of the box, it bobbles about a bit, and Nelson just lifts an awful one over the top, which somehow ended up at the feet of Christie, and he just smashed it in, one each. Then we looked like we were going to go on and win it. You know, they were panicking, we were really on the front foot. But like you say, I said coming down, Gav, I'd expect a draw, 1-1, 0-0. You know, like you say, we've seen a couple of goals, and it was a really good point. It didn't feel like a win, scoring that late, but it felt like a really well-deserved point. And then, so obviously, it makes the journey home a lot easier, not coming home dwelling on a defeat. Well, I must say about Craven Cottage, it's the strangest place, but the best place I've been to watch a game of football. You were sat in your seat, and you're watching the game, and you look to your left, and you've got the River Thames, and you've got them all messing about on the water, rowing in the boats, and it was just, like you say, the setting. You know, it was a joy to watch the game today there. It was really good, and the people were really good. And I must say that that's the loudest I've heard us this season. The support was absolutely outstanding. It was deafening. The passion and the feeling that comes from them supporters is absolutely fantastic.
Can I just say, Tom, as well, as how much I'm missing Jimmy at this point?
Oh, I'm missing him more.
I've
never been so stressed driving with all them loonies in London. It was a nightmare. I've never been so scared in my life, even though it's not my van. And I was petrified of
you got, seriously, Tony, you got through it so well.
Yeah, well, I had the death grip on the steering wheel.
So yeah.
Adios. Up the Borough, Gav.
See you, mate.
Good night, Tony.
See you later, mate.